Hello everyone, so welcome back to my channel again. In this video we are going to discuss about what are the important terms that we are using in arithmetic progression, right? In the previous video we have discussed already what is an AP, what is an arithmetic progression, but what are the important terms that we have to discuss in the arithmetic progression is the first term, that is A, about the common difference, that is D, about the nth term of AP, which is very very important, about the sum of n terms of AP, right? So let's start the video everyone. It's a very short video, so yeah, let's discuss that. Let's have a discussion on important terms that we are using in arithmetic progression. The terms are A, the small a, then we have D, then we have nth term of AP, then we have AN, and then we have SN. Okay, so these are the important five terms that we are using in arithmetic progression. So let's talk about that. So the first thing that we are understanding it with A, what is small a? For small a in AP is first term. Let's take any simple AP, right? Suppose I'm saying any AP, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so on. Means these dots means the AP is in continuous, means there are numbers after 10 also and they are in continuing, right? What is A? Small a represent the first term. So what is A here in this AP is A is equals to 2. So A means the first term, right? What is D? I told you in the previous video what is an AP, that what is D? D is the common ratio. Why common, sorry, difference, not common ratio, common difference. Difference means subtraction of two consecutive terms and it should be common at every point. Consecutive term means if you are making a difference of first two terms, so the difference is coming 2. If you are taking the difference of next two terms, so it will be also 2. If you are making the difference of next two terms, so it will be 2 again. So it means D at every point is the same. But D can be positive, it can be negative, it can be a fraction, it can be any integer, it can be any real number, right? So please remember this thing. So D can be anything. It can be an irrational number also. So it can be any real number. So here the difference is coming same. So that's why we are saying it as common difference, because at every two consecutive number, the difference is same. And we are representing common difference with small d, right? Next thing that we are getting get to know is nth term of AP. Nth term of AP means if I am talking about A2, so here n will become 2, means I am talking about the second term. Suppose I am taking this AP only, so 2 is A1, that is the first term, 4 is A2, that is second term, 6 is A3, 4 is A4, 10 is A5. So if I will ask you, nth term means AN, okay, and how I will write it, AN means A plus, we have already talked about the general form of AP in my previous video, what is an AP, go through that. So the general form of AP is A plus A, this is the first term, second term, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and so on. A is the first term, that is A1, A plus D is A2, that is the second term, A plus 2D is A3, that is the third term. And if you are seeing that always in the third term, the coefficient of D means the number in multiplication with D is 1 less than. If I'm talking about second term, the number in multiplication with D is 1, means 1 less. So when I'm talking about AN, so what is AN? So nth term of AP is A plus. We have to subtract 1 from this. So that's why this is the nth term of AP. If I'm talking about nth term, it can be second term, it can be 15th term, it can be 100th term, it can be any term you can say, right? That is AN. And N is always positive. Please remember, I can't say that Joe, please sit on seat number minus 5, because there is no seat number minus 5. So number of terms is always positive. So N will be always positive. It will always be greater than 0. Always remember, n will be always greater than 0, right? So yeah, that's that. This is nth term of AP. Now let's talk about AN. AN we have already talked about. So this is AN. Then we have is SN. Suppose I'm saying 2, 4, 6, 8. This is an AP. This is a finite AP because there are no terms after 8. If I'm putting dot, 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 then it means infinite AP. It means the numbers are in continuation. But here the dots are not there. So this is an AP only. Because this is an AP, because the difference between the two consecutive numbers are same. That is 2 only. Difference you are making of these two numbers same, 2. Of these two numbers same, and of these two numbers is also same. So that is why this is an AP. Now, if you are finding the sum of this term, so we know that what is N? N means the total number of terms. That is S4. And if you are adding the values, so you can get the sum of AP. So SN means the sum of N terms of AP. N terms. Here, how many terms are there? So N is equals to 4. So you can easily find out the sum of the AP by adding them, right? So this is all about A, that is the first term. And please remember, the first term is representing by small a, or you can write the first term as A1. Then D means a small d, that is a common difference with small cap, small d, right? Small alphabet. Then nth term means an, right? An, it can be any term, it can be 100th term, it can be 15th term, it can be second term, it can be fourth term, right? Then we have sm. Sm means whatever the numbers you have in the sequence, you have to add them. That is the sum of n terms of AP, right? So yeah, that's that all about. These are the terms that we are using in arithmetic progression, right? So yeah, thank you everyone. Thank you so much.